This is our cow trailer. It's quite an old one. The brakes were barely doing anything really. So I'm checking them all individually and I'm going to adjust them and we'll see how much life is left in them. But I have already done this side. I've done a bit of adjustment. So that's just about right. This side was a bit more bothersome. This shoe was hanging off like that. So it's worn unevenly. But it's not too big of a deal. There's plenty of life left in it. On the other side now, I haven't adjusted these yet. I'll clean them up a bit. I've had the same on this side. The shoe has slipped out of its groove. It's worn unevenly, which isn't ideal, but I'll put it right now. But to adjust it, get a flathead screwdriver in there, pull that back, and just twist that. I'll try that. That was way too tight.
So it's the first time we've done replaced bearings on a wheel hub. We've found out eventually that these are separate. Obviously it's a tapered roller bearing. They go in first, then your bearing goes in. I had to get a punch and punch these out from the underside. Three of them weren't so bad, but on this one, whether it's because the grease is, I don't know, it's that copper grease or whatever's wrong with it, but that one fell to bits. So as you can see, we've just ground all the muck off, and I'm now going to sand this in a bit, if I can clean my hands. And then we'll clean it up with some brake cleaner, and we'll put the new bearings in. So that's it cleaned out, so we'll put the new bearings in when I get any bits of metal out, or any grit or anything that's in there. Right, if you're looking here, you can see the slightly stepped, and there's a ridge there. So that goes in like that. So we'll stick a bit of proper grease on. The way I found to do this is just by luck, is I've got a metal disc that's just perfectly the right size. And just tap it in. There you go. That's in, as long as it's up to that ridge, which it is. I'll stick a bit more grease on. I'll stick a bearing in. So these bearings, they come like that. So you have to pack them with grease, which I kind of knew that, but I thought they'd have a bit of grease in, but they've nothing in. So back in Blue Peter, there's one I've already done. I just kept forcing it in and spinning it and then pushing more in. So that's completely packed with grease. So we'll chuck that in. Put a bit more grease on the outside. Just remember, I'm no mechanic. This is the first time I've ever put bearings in a hub. But I figured you might as well have a go. Dust seal, grease seal, call it what you will. Not a clue. There it goes. I'll just start it off. Try not to damage it. That feels about right. Right, chuck some grease on the underside of the bearing. Before I clean that off, I'll just grease the other side. Same with this one. Taper's bit in first, wherever it's called, I've got a clue. Like that. This drops in and then it. Oh, this is tight. But the one I took out was tight. This could be fun. Bit ready for the bearing. I've used proper grease, not just a general purpose. That's what we've used, that. Which I think is like a much better grease for bearings and bushes. I can clean all the grease off my hands, they're clean. Brake cleaner, no top. So I'll just wet this. Yeah. We've already put some brake cleaner on them. That one's worn a bit uneven, but I think it'll be fine for what we want it to do. When I was finally trying to get the bearings for this trailer, I didn't have a clue what they were, what code they were, what part number, anything. And they go off the year your trailer was made. Well, it turns out this trailer was made 34 years ago, so it hasn't done too bad for 34 years. So you've already seen that Adam's adjusted the brakes up, which is good bearing. Wash it, cast some up, we've got split pins yet, I'll get some new ones. Just going to nip it up, roughly. I That's not so bad, that runs pretty smooth. Adam's turn now to paint the wheels.
These are the wheels off the trailer. We haven't bothered masking these tyres up because we're going to replace these. You look at them, they're quite cracked. So we're going to spray them silver. We haven't got the big compressor here right now, so we'll just have to use this little one. This is the paint I'm using. It's literally Case IH silver. I'm just going to pour a bit in here, put some thinners in and thin it out, so we go through the spray gun.
Colors fading, 'cause I kept you waiting. It's a wild, wild world, and you're a wild, wild girl.
They've had primer, they've had the top coat, and they're going to put a bit of lacquer on, make them shiny, make them last. As you can see, they look pretty good. I've got some, I don't know what it is really, Amazon stuff, just some lacquer. How's that look? Not too bad. You know, when you think, I've got a fantastic idea, what I'll do is, I'll lacquer these wheels and it'll make the paint last longer. Well, it doesn't always go to plan. And this is what happened. If you can see, like that. So the lack has reacted with the paint. So I've had to strip them all off again. I've only done three, thank God. Alright, you see, I've already cleaned one back to metal. So we're back where we started. Doesn't always go to plan. Second one, rub down. As you can see, back down to metal again. I'm not quite sure why it's reacted, but the only thing I can think of is between putting the lacquer on and the top coat of silver spray, I wiped the wheels down with thinners and not panel wipe. So, you know, is that the reason? I don't know. If you do know the reason, leave us a comment or tell me why it's reacted. So what I've done now is I've ordered, a gallon tin like that of proper panel wipe, so that'll be here tomorrow, so I won't bother priming these until the panel wipe comes. But if you're wondering why the hell have we sprayed the tyres, it's because these two tyres are knackered, they're full of splits. So we're going to put two new tyres on these. The ones that I didn't lacquer, well, that's how they've come up. It would have been better to leave them, really, wouldn't it? Just like that. Head away. I'll do the last one now.
My sun's still shining, but it seems half the size, and it's a wild, wild world out here.
Before I put these wheels on, anybody that knows IFOR Williams trailers will know that these things are always squeaking, on the road especially. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to put some grease. You see the leaf spring there? I'm going to put some grease in there. Because that bit, it's got weight on it, touches the body. And I think, pretty sure that's what's squeaking. You can see the rust. Get some in there. I mean, it should do some good, shouldn't it? We did this on one of our other trailers and it made a big difference. So I'm hoping this will.
Before my time runs out, what if I run away to Mars? Would you find me in the stars?
This is a pair we're using, Case International Silver. It's already got some thinners in it, so I might be able to just go straight in the gun, we'll see.
Well, to me, that's a little bit too thick. So we'll just put a tiny bit of thinners in it. That. Use it back there. That should be enough. But I've got a fan in a window, which works. Compressor on, and off we go. I've only got a little compressor this time. Tiny one, but it works.
Would you miss me in the end if I run out of oxygen when I run away to mine?
Not if you can see, but it does shine. Pretty good. Good stuff.
So you join me again about 3 weeks later. The wheels are ready to go back on now.
After they've been resprayed, some of them twice. We've got some split pins ready. The hub's back on. New bearings in. These just want, maybe just want tightened up a bit more. And then I've got a selection of split pins here. I've also got IFOR WILLIAMS pop caps. These were about 55 quid. 55 quid for that, can you believe it? 55 quid for 4 plastic caps. Christ. Yeah, we'll pop them on. That's the first pin in. And I'll put this new cap on.
I can't tell which way's home. I've been gone for so long, it's an empty world up here.
Just putting some copper grease on the threads, not a lot. Just to make sure the wheels aren't stuck on there forever. They were black before, now we've sprayed them silver, just to help it look a bit more modern really. It is about a 34-year-old trailer, so it's not in bad nick really.
Before my time runs out, what if I run away to Mars? Would you find me in the stars? Would you miss me in the end if I?
That's it, that's all 4 wheels back on now. Including the 5th spare one. What I'd like to do next is jump in the pickup, leave the handbrake on, and try pulling the trailer forward. I want to see if the brakes want a bit more adjusting. I can just do it on a nut underneath. But I feel like they're going to be good enough, really. Anyway, we'll try it. So the handbrake is still up, I'll set off forward and we'll see what happens. They're definitely better, you can feel them, they are working, but I think they could go a bit tighter. Tighten them up a bit, just by the threads underneath, you just tighten up a bolt, I'll show you now. And it is a lot better, it does want tightening a little bit more, so I'll just show you. You've got a climb under here. And you've just got to twist this clockwise. You see? Just that clockwise. And that tightens it up. Next job, I've got these clips. Like that. You know what I mean? You can see they've got the chain on. So I'm just gonna drill a hole somewhere, maybe about there. Just so they never go missing. Just like that. Do the same on the other side now.
Would you find me in
thanks for watching us do this trailer up a bit. Like I say, it's about a 30-odd-year-old trailer, so it's in pretty good nick for its age, and the idea of spraying these wheels silver was just to help it look a bit more modern, really. They were black, they were pretty rusty anyway, so they could do with touching up. Like we've maybe said before, me and Father are both joiners. We're not mechanics, but you can't knock someone for trying, can you? I hope you've all learned something, because I have. As you may well know, trailers aren't cheap, so if we can make this one last for quite a while, then why not? So yeah, that's the trailer sorted for now. Brakes are all sorted, wheels painted, put them clips on the back. Not too long ago, I went over the whole back end with alley cleaner, and that seems to have really cleaned it up. Would you miss me in the end if I run out?